In this lecture, we are going to learn about ng template in Angular. The ng template is an Angular element which wraps an HTML snippet. And this HTML snippet acts and can be used like a template and can be rendered in the DOM. Let's try to understand ng template with an example. To understand ng template, here I have created a brand new Angular project called Angular ng template. In there, we have this app component. So if I open the app component.html file, here we have the default HTML of Angular application. So from here, I'll delete everything. Okay, and here let me go ahead and let me add an H2 element. And here I'll simply say learn ng template. And after this, we want to create a template. For that, we can use this ng template like an element. So as we learned, ng template is just an Angular element. So we can use it like any other HTML element. And inside this, we can write some HTML code, and that HTML will act like a template. So here what I will do is, I'll add an H3 element here, and I'll say this is a template. And let me also go ahead and let me add a paragraph element. And here let's also add some content for this paragraph. So here let's simply say this is an example paragraph to understand ng template. Okay, here I'm just writing some basic HTML because here our main intention is to understand this ng template. All right, with this, if I save the changes and if we go to the web page, in the web page you will notice that the outer H2 element has been rendered here. So basically, this H2 element is rendered in the web page, but this HTML, this has not been rendered in the web page, right? That's because when we create a template using this ng template, in that case, that template will does not render itself on the DOM. And the reason why this HTML is not rendered in the web page is because using this ng template, we are only defining a template. Now, it is our job to tell Angular where and when to display this template. And there are few ways in which we can display a template. One way is by using ng template outlet directive. So let's go ahead and here let's talk about ng template outlet directive. Now, this ng template outlet directive, it is a structural directive. That's because it is going to render a template in the web page. So it is going to manipulate the web page. That's why it is a structural directive. And in order to use this directive, first what we need to do is we need to create a template. And on that template, we need to specify a template reference variable. So we are creating our template here. This is our template. On this template, let's go ahead and let's specify a template reference variable. And let's call it maybe my template. You can name it anything, but I'll simply call it my template. And now, wherever we want to display this template, for example, let's say here, I want to display this template after this H2 element. Okay, so for that, what I can do is, here I can create a div. And on that div, I can use this ng template outlet directive. Something like this. And since it is a structural directive, we need to use an asterisk before it. And to that, let's go ahead and let's assign this template reference variable. Okay, so what we have done here, we created a template using this ng template. On that template, we have specified this template reference variable. And then in order to render this template at this place, first we have created a div. And on that div, we are using ng template outlet directive. And to that, we have assigned the template reference variable, which we have defined on this ng template. And now what this will do is, instead of rendering this div, now, in place of this div, this template will be rendered. That means this H3 element and this paragraph element will be rendered. Let's actually see that. If I go to the web page, now you will notice that that H3 element and that paragraph element has also been rendered. And if I inspect this web page, let's expand this body section in there. Let's expand this app root. So you see, first we have this H2 element. And then after that, we have this H3 element and the paragraph element. So this H3 element and this paragraph element, we have defined inside this ng template. So that is being rendered in place of this div. So with this example, I hope now it is clear what is ng template and what is its use. Basically, we use ng template to define a template, and then we can tell Angular when to render that template. Now let's understand the use of this ng template with some practical example. For that, let's open our ecart project. And before that, let's save these changes. Okay, I'll go to file, open folder, and then let's open this Angular ecart project. And let's open command prompt and let's run this project. So currently we are in this Angular ng template project. Let's go out of this folder. For that, I can say cd dot dot slash. So it will take us one folder up. Now we are in this folder, Angular complete course. From that folder, we want to move to this Angular ecart folder, which is our project folder. Let's press enter. And now we are in that folder. Here, let's say ng serve. So the project has been compiled and the live development server has been started. If I go to the web page now, and if I close this and if I rerun it, now our ecart project should be rendered. Now here, if I open the detail of any one of these products, let's say for the first product, and if I scroll down, you see here we have this button add to cart. Okay, and let me reload the page again, and let's open this unavailable product. And here also you will see that we have this button add to cart. But what we want is, we want to show this add to cart button only if the product is available. If the product is not available, in that case, instead of showing add to cart, we want to show maybe notify me. Okay, so when the user will click on that notify me button, whenever the product will be available, the user will be notified. For that, let's go back to VS Code and let's open our product details component. So it is in source folder. In there we have this app folder, there we have the container folder, and in there we have this product detail folder, and in there we have our product detail component. So let me open the HTML for this product detail component. Okay, and we are displaying this add to cart button somewhere here. So here we have this add to cart button. Okay, now we want to display this add to cart button if the product is available. For that, here I am going to use ng if directive. So that ng if is a structural directive, and in there I will say product dot, and we should have is in inventory, this property. So if the product is in inventory, that means the product is available, then only we want to display this button. So if I save the changes and if we go back to the web page now, let me reload the page. Okay, so if I open an available product and if I scroll down here, we should have this add to cart button. But if I open an unavailable product, maybe this one, and if I scroll down here, you see we do not have that add to cart button. But if the product is unavailable, instead of not showing a button, we want to show notify me button. So for that, let's go back, let's create another button element here. Okay, now this button should only be displayed if the product is not available. Okay, so here I'm going to create this button as a template, and here I'll simply call it notify me. Okay, and I'm going to create this button inside a template, and to create a template we can use ng template directive. Inside this ng template, let me go ahead and let me add this button, and on this ng template I'll add a template reference variable and I will call it maybe notify me. Again, you can name this reference variable anything. And here we are using this ng if directive. There we have specified this condition. So if this condition returns true, in that case this button will be displayed. Else what we want is, so after this condition we can use a semicolon like this, and we can say else, and we can specify this template reference variable here. Okay, so if this condition returns true, in that case display this button. But if this condition does not return true, if it is false, in that case this else part will be called, and in there the template with this notify me template reference variable will be rendered. So in this case, this template has that template reference variable, so this will be rendered. So with this, if I go to the web page, Let me reload the page again. So if I open this not available product and if I scroll down here, we still do not see that button. Let's see why is that. And that's because we should not have this ngif directive here. Okay. Let's save the changes. Let's go back to the web page. Let me open this unavailable product. Now if I scroll down, now you see here it is showing notify me. But if I open any available product, in that case it should show add to cart. Okay, let's refresh the page. All right, so this is all about ng template. As we learned, we use ng template to define a template, and then in order to render that template, we will have to tell Angular when and how to render it. This is all from this lecture. If you have any questions, then feel free to ask it. Thank you for listening and have a great day.